everyone, welcome to the Art of Flowers with Tulipina. Today I wanted to show you how I would create an arrangement with just a single ingredient. Unlike my usual stuff, I like to use many different ingredients, but I love Japanese anemones. As I said the last time, I think a couple times before, they're awesome and they're available right now. So here I am. I wanted to see if I could just do something with only anemones. As usual, I've got a vase that's pedestal. I've gone ahead and put my frog in there and some water, and I'm just gonna start building it and take it as it comes. So the way I think about the anemones, they have their own movement. So I like to think about which ones I put where and sort of listen to their shape and their little wiggly selves. So I'm just gonna start with this one on this side and then take it from here. I'm gonna see. And basically I want to create a shape. It's unlike my normal stuff because I always have foliage and then I build upon the I build a shape and then I build upon that shape. With flowers, but here I'm just using one ingredient, so it's I'm going to play around a little bit with it. I'm just starting my asymmetry. I like the way this one is bending downward, so I'm going to use that to my advantage. Cutting over here. If you follow me on Instagram, you will have probably read that last week my studio building was burned. And so I have to move out of that studio, as much as I love it, for at least temporarily, because the building has to go, has to undergo some renovations, and I can't be in there, even though my part didn't get hurt that much. I can't be in there while they're trying to rebuild my landlord's portion of the building. So I'm looking for a new space. It's going to continue with different heights along the vessel inside the frog. A little bit more cut over here. I like to use the buds as well. They give a nice texture to the whole arrangement. This year I didn't see that many white Japanese anemones, but there have been plenty of this more blush color, which makes me very happy. Just take some of the not so pretty leaves off. I'm just gonna rotate it a little bit to see what the back looks like. So then I just take a little step back to see what else I should do. I'm cutting some of these slightly shorter because I want to make sure that there are flowers all around the vessel and that you're not going to wind up with just a bunch of stems right here with all the flowers up top. Thank you. They get so twisted. Okay. A little bit shorter. And at this point, almost all of these anemones are in, I've put them inside the frog. Just because there was space. Once I run out of space, then I'll move out, or not out, but I'll just place things along the lip of the vase. And then I'm going to continue on filling the front now, or I should say the other side. Few more with some of the foliage in the front and shorter. This one right on the side. Another one down here. Basically, I'm looking for more of the open ones. You could also do this with poppies. They would be so beautiful. Basically any, I like doing them with ranunculus because they definitely have lots of movement, and the flowers themselves are really pretty and bendy. And so that makes for a lovely single ingredient arrangement. And at this point, I'm just putting my flowers wherever I can, because it has enough, the vessel itself right now has enough flowers in it that it's going to support everything sort of sitting in there. A lot of untangling. Here. And I want a few more open ones, which I'm pretty much running out of at this point, but I want to do one right here in the front and shorter one so that you could really see her face. One more here. Put a couple more of the buds in the back. I like to use these foliage, so if I cut the flower away from the foliage, then I can use the foliage better. So I do that with some of them. And then I'll add the stem back in. That way it's easier to manipulate how they sit. I'm going to take a few more and put them on the side here. And I'm pretty much done with all of my flowers. There's one more there. Well, this one is on its way out. Let's do, there's a little white one here. This one's from the garden. Just kind of include it in there. And there's one over here. I want to put right there. Maybe I'll put it up here. Let's see. I don't want it to feel stuffed, so I have to make sure that it's sitting freely among the rest of them. And I'm just sort of looking down to make sure it all looks nice. There's this one little white one. I'll use this one too. Why not? This one, another one on its way to opening. Just a little bit more. One down here. I just want to move this up a little bit more. And then I got a couple of these cup and saucers from my yard, just because they were about the same color palette. So I thought maybe I could use them, and I'm just gonna see what it would look like if I included them. It's a single ingredient arrangement with a few things here and there. I'm just gonna take this off because it's a little bit thick, so cut it a little and I'll put it right here on the side. Just for a little bit of an element of surprise. And one more. I love that they have all these different stages of changing colors. They, this one is sort of, this one here is green. And then this right here is getting a little bit darker. And this one is slightly older, so it's even darker, but I love that. Let's see. There's that. And I'll put one on the other side. The other day, as I was at the doctor's office, I found these lovely, I would say they're albino ivy. So I thought they were really cool. It's not every day you find a foliage that's pretty much white. So I cut a couple from the parking lot. No one seemed to care. And I'm gonna just use one here. I want it to sit a certain way, so I'm gonna play with it just a little to get it just to do that. There it is. And I'm just gonna get a few of these little ones to fill the front a little bit more of the lip. They will all open tomorrow and the vase is just gonna burst with anemones. I'm gonna just do one over here because it was lost over here and put it in the front like this. And just a few more if I can find ones that are on their way to opening. Not that many more. And maybe this one. But I just want the leaves, so I'm gonna cut this bud and put it right down next to the white one. Here and just down here. And a little bit of the foliage of the cup and saucer. And just making sure I didn't miss any. Well, maybe I'll use this one. This one is fun too. I like the little squiggly things they have in their foliage. And it just makes it really pretty next to the other cup and saucer. Like this one. There's that. And you can see the squiggly things I added right next to my cup and saucer here. And I'm pretty much done. I would have probably gone even further and put more flowers in there, but as you can see, I was done with whatever that was already opened. So, but this will look beautiful tomorrow morning because all of these will have opened up and it'll be much more full. And even if you were going to give this to somebody, it's probably better that you have some more buds versus fully opened flowers. I hope that you enjoyed watching this episode and that you will go look for a flower that you like and put it together in a vessel as a single ingredient. Thank you for watching.